Another Russian missile attack on the bruised and battered city of Zaporizhzhia has killed at least four people and left several others fighting for their lives in hospital. A church and a shopping precinct were hit by the rockets, emergency services having to cut through debris to reach those trapped under the rubble. As Russia shows no signs of stopping its attacks, Ukraine has ordered nearly 12,000 civilians to evacuate 37 settlements in the Kharkiv region near the Russian border. Moscow has been constantly shelling the area. Early this week, they bombed a blood transfusion center. Donald Trump has waived his right to appear in court, entering another not guilty plea via his lawyers to fresh charges in the Mar-a-Lago documents case. But the former president's valet and co-accused did appear, also proclaiming his innocence. Trump's property manager could not plead, as he is still to secure a Florida-based lawyer to act for him.
Mr. Irving, why no Florida counsel yet? Can you explain what happened?
I'll have more to say after Mr. Dale bears the clip.
The Washington, D.C. election interference case poses the biggest threat to Trump, and special counsel Jack Smith has asked for a January the 2nd start date. The former president's lawyers are expected to demand a delay. Las Vegas police have released a dozen hours of body cam footage showing the moment they raided a property over the 1997 murder of rapper Tupac Shakur. This is the moment self-described gangster Dwayne Davis is ordered out of the home.
Keep walking back. Take a step to your left. Step to your left. Okay, hey, face away from me. Face the house.
60-year-old Davis is the uncle of Tupac rival and a one-time suspect in the rapper's killing. Police also took computers, bullets and hundreds of photographs from the property. Flooding has forced thousands from their homes in the southeast of Norway as experts warn more is to come. Days of torrential rain has swollen rivers and triggered landslides through the mountainous landscape. Damage is already estimated at more than $1 billion, and it is expected to take months to repair train lines, roads and bridges. The rain has eased, but the volume of water streaming out of the hills means that the threat of more damage remains. Large parts of Canada's capital are underwater after severe storms moved across the city. More than 5 centimetres of rain fell on Ottawa in just an hour and a half, sparking flash flooding and stranding drivers. This is just the latest extreme weather event affecting Canada, with dozens of wildfires still burning across large parts of the country. Three amateur astronauts have made history on Virgin Galactic's first tourist flight, venturing to the edge of space. A British Olympian, along with a mother and daughter from the Caribbean, were on board, experiencing zero gravity and an incredible view of the planet we call home.
Blasting off into a new frontier of space tourism, Virgin Galactic rocketing towards the edge of space.
3, 2, 1, release, release, release.
This is the company's first flight with tourists on board, mother-daughter duo Keisha Shahaf and Anna Myers, and British Olympian John Goodwin, an 80-year-old living with Parkinson's.
And they are officially astronauts. Welcome to space. Woo.
The hour-long journey takes passengers 90 kilometres above Earth, where the view is extraordinary.
The planet where all of their experiences are held, everything they've ever known is down below.
The launch and landing was perfect, the spacecraft eventually gliding back down to the New Mexico desert after making history.
Without a doubt, the most exciting day of my life.
It was really the best ride ever. And you could say, I would do this again, and I would love to do this again.
At 18, Anna is the second youngest person to travel to space. For her, it was a dream come true, and proof the sky is no longer the limit.
You felt like a part of the team, a part of the ship, a part of the universe, a part of Earth. It was incredible, and I'm still starstruck.
If you fancy a flight, tickets are available, but prices are out of this world. A single seat will set you back $700,000. John Paul Gonza for 10 News First.
The world's most popular bath toy has made quite the splash in the Chicago River. The Ducky Derby attracts tens of thousands of competitors to the city, all raising money for a ducking good cause, that is the Special Olympics Illinois. Participants sponsor a rubber duck of their choice for $5, and then racegoers vie for the best spot to cheer on and quack on their ducky to victory. At the end of the day, there's only one lucky duck taking out the top spot.